Amen.
Amen.
God.
Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. For in my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I was going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." "Lord," said Thomas, "we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" And Jesus said to him, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except for me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
But we're all here today God home, he didn't know, he didn't say that he knew him as a stranger, but he knew him as someone that Jesus loved. Everyone goes away. And they forget that this family each Susan and her whole family up there, be each and every one of you. And at different locations in life. You have a husband, you have a location to be a father, you have a location to be a brother, you have a location to be a parent, and all those different locations, God said to them, I want you to touch certain people's lives, and provide for them the gift of memories. Help me memories of all of your life. You know, God's not going to take them away. He's going to have a need for a good memory. He's going to say to you, here's that memory that I want you to have. One of the things that so many people have told me about is that sure, he liked to win, but he had class when he won, but he also had class when he lost. And it was something that was very, very important to sure, you get a little angry. Disappointed, but we have to treat one another with respect. We have to have class. One of the things that Greater City Eastern Band is very well known for is class. And Bob was the one who tried his best to make sure that this was a class filled Eastern Band and so many others. So we have a very special wedding. Sad that we didn't come back. We know that he did his very best. And now he has no more pain. He has no more suffering. He has a great spot in the kingdom of heaven. Probably the Lord Jesus had to extend the ceilings in the kingdom of heaven. Because he probably said, short people go this way, and tall people go that way. So he's probably got his head in the clouds. But the Lord is saying to each and every one of us, we have to remember the importance of being class-filled. You didn't see that. One of the things that thank you. ask our God to hear these prayers and petitions that come from deep within our hearts. To each petition, please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. God the Father Almighty, raise Christ His Son from the dead. With confidence, we ask Him to hear these, our prayers and petitions. For Bob, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Amen.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us in this life, that they may have the reward of their goodness, let us pray to the Lord. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord. For Susan, that God will watch over her and protect her, and allow her to always hold the great memories of her relationship with God here on earth, we pray to the Lord. For Bob's brother and his children, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of Lazarus, his friend, we pray to the Lord. For all of us assembled here to worship with the Father, that we may be gathered into the eternal kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
One of the things that we hear so often at the time of the death of our loved ones is, Father, I never got around to saying, our God says to you at this time to bow your heads, to close your eyes, and say those things to God that maybe you did not get around to tell. We pray to the Lord. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for all our departed sisters and brothers. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
our good and Bones Church. Pleased to meet you. I'm good.
May this vow of obligation be acceptable to you, O Lord, that by the power and the sanctity of our manner of life, and being for us a very special place in the Father's kingdom, wherever you cheer with white joy. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our King and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have chosen to call our Lord God from this life, and to prepare for
Spirit.
death, you will reconcile us to yourself. Pray that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with this Holy Spirit, may we become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your life, especially those of us who are Mary, the Mother of God, who seek to encourage us. With Stephen, Patrick, and all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages, for we may inherit them, co-heirs of eternal life, and follow your intercession, that we rely on your unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation be bright, advance the peace and salvation of all the world, be pleased to be preferred in the power of faith and charity. Your public church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Charles, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire you have made for your own. This is the gracious gift of the prayers that we offer for those that we give back to our God. Gather them to yourself. Bring to yourself all those who are scattered throughout the world. Remember our brother Bob, who took all of this world and brought to the world that is no more. Pray that we who are united with your Son in a death like this may also be one with him in the resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have fallen asleep and transform our lowly body. After the pattern of his own glorious body, who bowed with all of our departed brothers and sisters, and in all who were pleased to you at the time you were passing from this life, give kind attendance to your kingdom. There you will enjoy forever the fullness of your glorious glory, when we will enter the Father's kingdom, and you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you are God as we are, we shall remember you for all the ages and praise you forever until the end of time. We're with you, and in you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, the glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Gracious. Good afternoon. It is really a very fine day. For we've been gathered in this place, in this warm church, this beautiful service led by love, to gather as family and friends to say farewell for now, Donnelly, to say thank you to a good man who made a difference in the lives of his family and far beyond. Bob Shannon had the biggest hearts in the mountain of class, pride, commitment. I am honored that the Shannon family asked me to deliver this eulogy. I suspect they asked me to do it because they thought I was the only one who could get through it. I can't promise that I love him. Bob was everything's fun. Ever since then, was there for anything that Kelly, Marie, Elizabeth, Mann ever did. I saw the same in myself. I was brought up a military family, very formalized. One thing you would always, if someone was older than you, referred to in a certain way, and I was a little older than that. But also, the public was around me, formalized. So my mom, I greeted them, I called them not Bobby or Bob, I would often say, Mr. Ambassador or Captain. Just for them to be able to. But Bobby always greeted me almost always the same. And he would say, how do you do about anything I can do for you? And he really wanted to know, that's the difference. You likely heard the same from me regularly. And maybe we should make that Bobby Shannon greeting routine in our home lives. The late Jerry Rosa, captain of the 30th Street Band, called Bob the Mr. Mike. Jack Keane, former captain of battle on the Street Band, grew up watching Bob. Bob was at his prison. As Jack puts it straight and clear, he was the world's most famous woman. Bob Shannon was the face of my mind much of the world. He earned the title Mr. Ambassador, and he's on everyone's not rushing for the moment. The respect for Bob went across all the divisions. And some of you are familiar with the comic division. You might know the obviously Murray Comic Club. You might know Mike Sterling in that club. Well, Mike's dad is especially known as Mr. Clown. Go to the Mummers Museum. He's the one that teaches everybody who goes there how to spell. Mike Sterling loved his dad. I cannot tell you how much Mike Sterling loved his dad. But Bob said, and Mike said to me one day about Bob, Bob loved Mummery as much as my dad. Pride. Bob was proud of America, Philadelphia, and the Mummers. He was a proud Baker City Spring Man and his immediate family. Bob would actually be very nervous in the years to the point of maybe even wanting to throw up. He persevered through once he died out there and started working. It's that pride and commitment to doing what you're doing. He wore so many other hats and not all the sequins and feathers. For example, he was president of the Mummers Association, director of the Spring Man Association, historian, defender of the great Philadelphia tradition. He worked for our nation in the Defense Department. He worked behind the scenes working out differences from television in the city of Philadelphia. He was overjoyed working for the Phillies. He became an attraction himself. And he's the first guy you looked for when you went to the ballpark. People were taking pictures with him. Baker City and Bob would say the band was the recipient of the joy and kindness of the people of that town. Susan says the children there doing this. Big Bob, they taught him how to sing It's a Long Way to Tipperary. And he would lead them in a march to have this image of like a pipe piper. That's exactly what it was. Bob's leadership started early in his mid-1960s high school when he welcomed people from Dartmouth Bowl and Niagara Falls. Bob was a kicker on the football team, a center on the basketball team, played on the baseball team, and also played baritone saxophone in the band. He was an Eagles fan early. He was a Philadelphia Eagles band in the 1960s. Growing up, Bobby had his brother Jack, who was always calling Bob brother. Even as the decades went on, they still found time to talk to each other regularly, at least once a week. Bob loved to celebrate. He came to even more like a serenade or at a parade and after a parade. The gangster year, the great performance, Bobby was celebrating pretty good. Kevin Ripple, his son-in-law, found him asleep in a chair by his locker. Bob tried to wake him, not really wake him up, kind of turn. Bob sort of settles down to the floor, gets comfortable again, and continues sleeping. Kevin didn't know what this kind of cat did. So he finds Jack. He says, Jack, what are we going to do? Jack assesses the situation, looks around, grabs a big bass fiddle, pops, case, lays it over Bob. He said, you haven't stayed here tonight. Bob did a lot of charity work when he wasn't using a bass fiddle cover as a mic. Sometimes raising money in fun ways, including more recently dancing for our future stars, and that benefited in his mission schools. At home, Bobby liked watching NCIS, Big Bang Theory, like soft jazz, all kinds of music, Italian food. He enjoyed hanging with the Bacon Brothers when they were here. But there are some other things about Bob. One reality is that if he was home, say the Phillies or Eagles were on, and the team wasn't playing all that well, the call went the wrong way. 6'10" Bobby could get really loud. The neighborhood became informed instantly that there was a bad call. Bob loved his Wednesday dining and sleep most of the night at Sugar House. He liked the word outstanding. Bob loved to tell jokes, and he was not good at it at all. Eventually, he would come to accept that he wasn't very good at everything, and liked the very attention he would get for messing up. And so it became a big family thing, and a friend thing that he did it around between a friend and the band Bob. In fact, he loved it so much that when I saw him this morning, for an instant, I thought he was playing another crime house. He looks so good. The man hasn't stopped any show. Commitment. Bob was proud of Baker City, of all true mummers and of his family. He was committed to both and to his city of brotherly love. He learned from Ray and Chris and from his dad, Robert Sr. and Baker, and all the dads and fellow Baker kids. Most importantly today, Bob is remembered as Bobby, as Daddy, and as Poppy, remembered and honored as a husband, father, and grandfather. Our hearts have poured out over the last week and will continue to as you take Bobby's advice about staying in touch. To his wife, Susan, to his children, Andrea, Nadine, Christopher, Daniel, and to the 5 grandkids Poppy loves so much, Paige, Lily, Lily, Hannah, and Joseph, and all of their immediate families. The kids, adults now, Nanny also very close, and that great smile and really good words. Bobby knew how you felt. Christopher, he was so proud of you. So proud. He talked about you to me with pride. Nadine, the middle child, your Shannon, through and through, the troublemaker, the mischievous but lovable one. Andrea, fair to say, the leader of the pack. She was calling other folks and Quaker uncle and aunt from the beginning. She'd go to the rehearsals early on as a child. She even went on the bus on trips to other parades or other gigs and sat in the back with some of the other kids, all boys. So Bobby had Yes, he wanted to make sure of her other hand. Andrea eventually married into another great Bummer family, the Little family, but a week before they got engaged, Kevin went to Bummer and asked his permission to marry Andrea. Bobby was overjoyed, but that was a problem that you can imagine. Kevin all week said to himself, "What have I done? There's no way Bobby can contain himself and not still be." On the day of this proposal, Andrea walks in, and Bobby is smiling ear to ear like a string from a smile, and starts hugging her and all kinds of things, and won't, like, leave her alone. And Kevin got off on this time. But guess what? Bobby hung on just a little bit longer, and Kevin was able to do the formal proposal. Bobby loved his grandchildren. He was the ultimate grandparent. Surprise donut drop-offs on his way to work, cupcakes from Port Richmond, playdates in the park. Grandkids called him Poppy. They had a diner he liked, and they called it Poppy's Diner. And he brought pizza, which was offered as Poppy's Pizza. Poppy loved being in the corner of the room where the kids were and the grandkids were watching everybody play and talk. He was really sentimental. He would cry or get emotional at the drop of a hat. His grandkids kept smiling, he'd start tearing up. Someone was having difficulty, he'd tear up. He'd win an award. Talk about a band, you gotta get a roll of paper towels. He had a big heart. But Bobby was even more than that in his Pecco Douglas. Susan says of Bobby, "He was my heart, he is my heart." Susan, Bobby talk about you all the time. Good things. You and Bobby didn't have to go anywhere you have it. Where you were is where he was happy to be. Susan tells a story, though. She tells me a lot about his relationship with Quakerson. She tells a story that they started seeing each other. It's getting serious. Bob said, "Hey, I want you to meet some people close to me. We're meeting at the Quakerson City Clubhouse." She's thinking, you know, of Dan and Mom. And they've been together in Port City, but not at that time. This was in the early days. So she's thinking maybe a family or two, a couple of bandmates maybe. She and Bobby walk into Quaker City, and the entire band was there. You couldn't find a seat, Susan and the band. Quaker City is there. Which really was, and it is possible, actually. Harry Brown Jr., the president of Quaker City, is in awe of his own band. At least 80 plus playing members last night. Performing "Let Me Sing" and "Never Fully Dressed Without a Smile." She can tell from her father, can tell from me, and you certainly know from Bob. Smile is a key word. Bob got what number is all about. It's about making people smile. And in Harry's words, it's about how you all have been in Quaker City and all your friends in the past week and last night and this morning and today. Be another word of Bob, like he's another word. Immaculate. At his retirement meeting, there was a quote on the program you may recall from Bob, "A band can walk up the street without a captain, but a captain cannot walk up without his band. It has been a pleasure." Bob stood tall for the elderly and the very young, for those in pain and grieving, the dying, the depressed, and distraught, being there for children, consoling them, serenading aging mummers in the final days and hours of their life. He had the biggest of hearts. Just for the days before he passed on, Bob played in the park with a grandchild. He attended the Springdale Association banquet with Susan. He marched for Gloucester City in St. Patrick's Day Parade. Life was on the upside. He was doing definitely all the things he loved. You know that Righteous Brothers song, "If there's a rock and roll heaven, you know they've got a heck of a band." Well, we know heaven's got one awesome Philadelphia Lovers Parade. No time living, no short parade. Standing in that bar, but I believe he's going to get that same beer today and asking them how they're doing and help. May I suggest that we could never love each other enough? It may be impossible, but please feel good to me. Bobby Bird, especially his immediate family. Susan is quicker sitting there. Bobby Bird, he knew. He had the wisdom of 2 Street and the wisdom of Broad Street. Words don't always come, but he was always grateful around me about you. He talked of you and your appreciation of him and what each of you meant to him as daddy, mommy, captain, and ambassador. I believe Bobby would like to want you to mourn a little today, but also to leave Our Lady in our home happier and a little wiser before you walk in. Bobby is giving us today what he gave us a chance to do as he strutted and spent time with us. Perhaps the first thing we should all think of was one of his favorite songs, When You're Smiling. He's given us a chance to be better than we have. He's helped us laugh, to grow, to smile, to sing, to dance, enjoy baseball, and appreciate one another. So whether Mr. Ambassador, grandfather, husband, brother, mummer for 6 decades, captain, president, director, community leader, historian, volunteer, passionate Philadelphia sports fan, American, ambassador of goodwill, friend of all, Robert Shannon Jr. made you and makes you feel today like the most important person in the world. Bobby, thank you. My pleasure.
Love of Christ. Everyone to please go right to their cars at this time. Thank you very much.